I got this message, a WhatsApp message from a MGTOW guy that men go in their own way. And this is what he said on the message. I don't have interest in getting married, but my question is, when one gets old, how will such said, let me repeat it, he said, I don't have interest in getting married, but my question is, when one gets old, how will such said individual handle this in terms of when I get old, will I live alone, no wife, no children? Of course, I'm enjoying my singles, but will it be hard at old age? In other words, what I will say here is, the question simply is summary is like, oh, you are scared to age alone, period. You are scared to be old or to age alone. Or some people might even put it to die alone. Now, there are some things here that could be very hard to explain, because in this case, I don't even know how to explain this. Solitude life or monk life is something you desire. So it's not like, oh, you are choosing it, you know, you are forcing yourself because, oh, you don't want that, but something is forcing you to do that. Because what you are trying to do now is, you basically don't really have that desire. Because something you have desire for, you know, you are craving for it. So you are looking for excuses why you don't want to live your solitude life. So you are just looking at, you know, oh, what if this, you know, oh, I don't want to be married. However, I don't want to die alone. You know, I don't want to stay without women when I get old. I don't want to live alone when I could have five children at old age, fucking around me, giving me headache, or making me happy. Oh, I want to, you know, that's what I'm saying. You see yourself. You are bringing in resistance, meaning that because if you really want something, if you really desire something, what usually happens is every other thing will be shut down, cut off from, you know, your mind, because your mind will so focus on that. You don't, unless you don't understand what I mean by desire. When you desire something, even if you can't have it, it's like, oh, I will do anything to get that thing. No matter the negative consequences that comes with it, you will find, you even remember or even think about whatever the cost that comes with it. So that's the thing. Monk life is not something, you know, you try to logic into it. There's no logic to it, because logic is like, okay, trying to rationalize sometimes or trying to add one or two. Logic is good, you know. But in this case, because everything has negative and positive, in this case, trying to apply logic to this or why you should go monk or be a monk, I think it will not serve you. Let me put it another way. What you're not saying, because the reason why I'm putting this, you are trying to make it look like it's bad for a man to live alone. Because at old age, it's going to be a problem for you. However, it's not a problem when a man lives alone as a priest, as a reverend father who is not married. Now, understand me, I want you to pay attention. It's not because you didn't bring in that logic. Okay, so to you, is acceptable the reverend fathers who have chosen to live a celibate life. So, it's not a problem because of why? No, it's not a problem if you are serving God by living a celibate life is better. In fact, you are even more respected and honored to be a saint, to live a solitude life as long as you are serving God. Nobody judges you. Nobody. It's not even a problem. It shouldn't even be a problem not to have a kid if you are a reverend father. But it's a problem when you are not a reverend father and now decides to stay alone. That is not because it now becomes bad. Oh, but what if? It means that it's not good for you to stay without children, without women. No, you see, that's what I'm saying. You are not really. You are trying to force yourself into something you don't desire. You know, even if you still desire, not now, because right now. For another example, I want to give is, what about the monks in the monastery? You know, there are so many all kinds of monks. Some are living in the monasteries. Some are just staying somewhere in the woods, cut off from the Gnosenti society completely, as in they stay off, even from other kinds of society. They live on their own with dogs, wolf or something like that. They just stay there, you know. They want to live and move on when their life is done. You know. Are you not saying all the monks in the monasteries, to them, it's okay for them to choose not to have women in their life, even at old age, or choose not to have children, so that is a problem for them to... Okay, to you, it's not a problem to them, because you didn't cite them. Or even remember that there are men who actually do that, but it's okay for this man to leave that, but someone who is not serving God and now decide, or not really serving God, because if you really want to talk about serving God for a Christian or a religious man, you can't really say it's only when you are wearing white robe that's when you are serving your God, because God, there's no specific division on how to serve God. You can serve your God in various ways, so you can choose to wear white robe and serve your God. You can still choose to be a married person and serve your God, like some of the pastors are doing. Pastor Pentecostal churches, church pastors. Yes, they're serving their God, but they are married. So you can't really say, oh, it's okay to serve God without being married. But if you are married, you are not serving God. So sometimes, that's what I'm saying. It's not really, if don't apply logic in this thing, it's fine. It's more like you are contradicting yourself. Now let's move away from religion. Even though I know some monks are not actually religious, because most of them are mostly spiritual, not religious. Now let's talk about the right brothers. What you are enjoying now, the eloquence you are enjoying now, are you telling me that we are not bothered about, if they were bothered about, how can I live old without children? Do you think you would have invented it, this pain you are enjoying? Of course, you know they are not married, the two of them. They are not married, they are no children, no wife. Let's talk about Nikola Tesla. Unless you don't know him. You think he would have been the inventor what he did and be the famous man he was if he was married? To him, no, he was exception. He's an exception. He shouldn't be married, unless that's what you're saying. What about Isaac Newton? He was not a married man. Did he die young or die old? What about Leonardo da Vinci? Was he a married man? Yes, he died as an old man. What does that mean? Does it mean he was so unhappy that he was regretting that there were no children around him or women around him when he was old? Should I go on? What about your Jesus Christ? I believe you are a Christian. How come he was not married? Or you mean you to tell me, well, there are many versions of his life out there. I'm talking about the point of crucifixion. Was it bothered? Let me not even go that side. You may say, oh no, he is a god. So I'm not going to argue with you on that. What about the apostles? Were any of them married? Oh, that one is even the same. What about the prophets, even before the coming of Jesus? How many of them were married? Or you want to tell me all of them died young? They didn't live up to 100. You know, that back then, now they aged beyond 100 years. In fact, it was even worse for someone to die. To them, dying 100 years itself even means you died young. They lived beyond 200 or whatever. And so if they were that old yet, it wasn't a problem to them. But now it's a problem now to you to start thinking, what about not having women around you at old age? I could go on and on. Seriously. I could go on and on. I don't want to start calling out men who actually lived old, lived and transitioned at a very old age, who were not married or had children. Well, you know, it's look as if I'm trying to compare. I'm not trying to compare anybody because you have to choose and live your own life. The other people's life may resonate with you, their lifestyle, but you still have to make a choice. You can pick one or two from what they are living that resonates with you, but it doesn't mean you have to be a copycat of every other person around you. You know, you have to live your original life. So trying to bother yourself about, oh, what about, it means you are not really prepared. Or it's not really what you want. You are just looking for any reason. You know, if you desire it, see, you don't need to be convinced. That's where I'm going. If you're willing, maybe you desire to have children. And there's nothing wrong with it. So there's no point saying, ah, I don't want to get married. I don't want to. No, you can actually have children without getting married. The marriage is a very stupid thing man invented for no reason. I don't even understand. Look at other animals. Or you think human beings are better than other animals. How many of them are married? Yet they are producing and doing everything. So I don't understand why men invented marriage in the first place. Of course, they did it because they want to slave for women. You know, tie themselves to one woman and slave themselves for that. Men naturally accept themselves as disposable assets, you know. It's not a woman's problem. Men chose to be, they don't care. You came to her and wanted to kill yourself for her, give her everything, do everything for her. She didn't put any gun on. Even if she puts gun on your head, you still have a choice to say no. Worst case, she will put the trigger and you will move on to another, your spirit life. So you only have that choice. Nobody can make you be a husband if you really don't want to. If they give you automatic, yeah, put you in jail if you don't want to get married. It's still a choice. You can choose to be in jail rather than getting married to somebody you don't want. You always have that choice. So it's not a matter of, oh, you know, I don't have any choice. No, you do. So men chose to. So I don't know two ways about it, and they are still choosing to do that. If you want to get married, go and get married. If you want to have children, go and have children. But don't say, oh, I want to go MGTOW. I want to be a monk, but I'm worried that I won't have children. I'm worried that I won't have a wife at old age. It means that's not what you really want. At least right now, it's not your desire. It's not in you. It's something, if it's in you, right now, I'm not bothered. I'm not even sure. You see, let me put it in a different way. All my life, I've never had any thought. You know, sometimes we've just been having thoughts about future and all those things. Ah, where you think it will be in the next 10 years, 20 years. Never have ever envisioned, you know, having children around or having a woman nagging or bitching at me. Honestly, it has never been in my plan, in my thought, in my imaginations. Never. Of course, back then I was still trying to follow the society. Yes, I will get married at some point, but I was imagining it like, oh, imagining myself carrying children up and down. Never. So that's what I'm saying. If you have that hunger to live a solitude life, and you only see yourself as a solitude man, if you're just like me, I cannot think I can stay with someone, as in live with someone for many hours. I will be so frustrated. So to you, if staying without another human being is a big problem for you, then it's not meant for you. Everybody cannot be a monk or go his own way. Some people, there are some men, you know, men are already programmed. Their mind are so focused that, or programmed to the point that they can't see themselves without women. As in, to them, is death. If they can't change vagina, if they can't live vagina, if they can't slave for vagina, let me put it this way. If they cannot put shame on themselves for vagina, it's like they don't have any purpose in life, then so they can as well die. That's how most men have been programmed from birth to feel. They will do anything. He wants to talk to them that, you can actually live your life. They will see you as if, no, something is wrong with you. How can you tell me that not having children, not living with a woman, is good for you? If they will shoot you, they will kill. Men, see, men can do any kind of thing. All the woman needs is point at this person and say, get rid of him. They don't need reason. They will get rid of you immediately just to satisfy that woman. That yes, because he's already, he has accepted to be a slave to her. I don't know how else to put it. So, the honest answer is, you still need to ask yourself truly, if you are so bothered about future, you are not even sure you are going to live up to. You know, that's the thing. People focus so much in the future, and they will mess, and they are messing up their right now. You are so bothered about future, you are not sure you are going to live up to. And you are living, you are missing out your current now. What if probably in the next 10 years, you could be so wealthy that you can afford to adopt up to 5 children? If you really want children around you at your old age. As if you already know what your future will look like. What if you may not even live up to, I don't know, before you get old? Or what if you eventually get that old? You see, let me explain to you. Do you think old men, their life is much better than you right now? You think there is a joy being living as an old man? I don't think so. When you can't even lift your finger. When you can't even tell the difference between rice and beans in your tongue, you put food in your mouth and they all taste differently. They taste almost tasteless. When you can't even jog, you can't even do anything. In fact, at old age, they are pumping all kinds of drugs inside your body for you to stay alive because of chemicals probably injected in your body at younger age. Trust me, I'm not saying you should check out before you get old, but to be seen, to be imagining that old age is when the little wife, the little sweet wife starts. Guy, you are mistaken. This is life. It's your own younger age. That's when you actually have that life. At old age, you are becoming a liability to other people. I'm being honest. There's no point. Why would I sugarcoat words? At old age, you are a liability already. Yeah, the children you have or everything may be taking care of you, but you are a headache to them. Yeah, but they will tell you they are not. They are doing all those things. But then, you kind of, sometimes, you know, somebody needs to stay and take care of you. I may limit their plans in life. Because if they need to travel, like, if they do to do certain things, like, they can because you are there. And somebody has to do it. Some people may not like what I'm saying. They feel like, oh, are you saying your parents is your abandoned? It's a very bad thing. But I'm telling you, don't see old age as a blessing to the living like that, or as a good thing you should look out for. Enjoy your life now is what you focus at your age, young age. When you get old, whatever happens, you deal with it. But when you look at look at that person very well. See the pains going through there. They may not be telling you even to walk. They are walking with pains. All their feet, all their hands, everything is pained. Even though it may not be as painful as that, but they can't even stand up erect. They can't keep their hands straight. Because they are losing the energy. The body is depreciating. It's going. And it's no longer as sweet as when you used to be young. So old age is not something you do, you know. You waste all your youthful life, all your this thing, not doing anything, not enjoying your life, not being happy, so that at the old age, you start to be happy. You are waiting until your children grow up for you to start living your life. Come on. I'm saying, you need to actually go back and reflect on what you are doing, if truly that's what you want. If you still, because it's more like your mind, you still have that gynocentric belief. It's still inside you. It doesn't matter what you say. It's about what how you react, what you do. You might tell people, I'm going to make that, but right inside you, you still held on to being a slave to the society or to women or to this thing, because it's still stuck somewhere that how can you live without people around you at old age? Who's going to help you? Who helped all those men? Who told you that at old age, if you are staying alone, you can't do certain things for yourself? Well, what makes you think at that old age you won't be rich enough to employ services to come and help you? And what makes you think at old age that you'll be happy? Maybe you can no longer, you are bedridden. You can't even move from your bed. You stay in your bed. And you think you will be happy. Your children will no longer be able to go to school or go back to town for their businesses. They have to stay there to be bathing you in bed, to be feeding you on the bed, to be, everything you do, they will have to be there because somebody has to do that. So they have to sacrifice their own well-being, sacrifice their future, sacrifice their happiness for you to live. That's not the life I want. So if that's what you want, but it's compelling, you don't have children, you don't have it, then I think your perspective of life is still gynocentric. Going MGTOW, going your own way, walking away for women is just 5% of it. The main reason of living your own life is more than just about women. That's why you don't see me talking about women, doing video on women and all that. I don't have that time because to me, in fact, women are even helping me to live my life. Because what they are doing is reminding me why I should focus on my life. Because they are living their life selfishly. Because men are doing everything, killing themselves for them, doing everything they say. Without them doing. In fact, even when they don't want, men will come and put their head, put shame on their neck and give them and say, no, demand, you have that from us. Get everything you want from us, even if we have to kill ourselves in your presence for you to be happy. So, yeah, they are using that advantage to get whatever they want. So, it's not their fault. So, that's what they're reminding me, that we're all here to live selfish life. But for some reason, men lock their own selfish life and say, no, women, you are the only one that have that right and permission to live selfishly. While we, the men, know we have to slave and die selflessly for you guys. So, there's nothing wrong. Women are not doing anything wrong. It's men that chose to live miserable. So, honestly, that's all I have for this. If you want to know how men who were famous, the genesis we've had in the past, so many things that were lived old age, and we are hearing their name right now, thousands of years ago, they passed. Yet, some of the things they invented as solitude men, that's one of the things you are enjoying now. So if you want to know, you can go and research on them, how they lived their life and as old age, so that maybe that may inspire you. But to me, if you need somebody to convince you whether to go monk life or get married, then it means you still have a lot of work to do on yourself, because nobody can make that decision for you. I can't make you seek my desire. You know, what you should be seeking your own desire. Maybe look for somebody that shares same desire with you and discuss it. But if you're seeking, if you still the one want to get married, yet your belief is something is wrong when you don't get married, because you are going to suffer for it at the end, then you want to get married. You are just saying you don't want to get married, but then you have your belief is that it's wrong for not to get married, because you will suffer for it at the end. So that's the end of this video. You have to go back and look at what you really want, not what I want.